Good afternoon, Water Rat families. I hope this finds everyone doing well. I wanted to send this video message rather than inundate your inbox with a lengthy and wordy email. So I will hopefully be able to keep this as condensed as possible while getting a lot of information to you. First and foremost, hey, next time you come into the pool, whether it be the observation deck or come in to swim yourself, I hope you notice that we have the new Colorado board is up, it's functioning, and that Water Rat logo is proudly displayed. So it's great to see that and thank the Y for their support in seeing that we get the new scoreboard. To our new 8-and-unders who got a chance to have their first swim meet also here at the Y, parents learning how to time, great just being able to have that first meet of the season for the 8-and-unders here, where they know the environment and it's not as daunting, and hope and know that that was a really good experience for them, so we feel good about that. And then we had the opportunity for the rest of the team to compete this past weekend up at Massac High School at the Rapids Fall Festival. So as of now, every Water Rat has had an opportunity to compete. We have a number of girls who are competing and representing their high school programs right now, so they've been up and going for quite some time. And before you know it, that season will come to end, and then we'll be talking about the boys that are also into their high school season. So I wanted to talk about a couple of things. Coming down in November 12th to the 14th is our huge age group qualifier, and I say huge because we switched from the Freestyle Frenzy this year to the qualifier, and the interest is tremendous. We have a team coming in from Metropolitan Swimming. We have a number of teams from throughout the state that don't normally come here or have not been to the Y in quite some time. So we really look that to be a nice deep meet and giving everyone an opportunity to get some good races across the board, which will really be our last competition before we head into our mid-season meets. And to discuss that, that's really been a challenge of where we're going to go, what are we going to do, and some hard decisions have had to be made through a lot of discussion, a lot of research, a lot of going back and forth and really bouncing things off with the staff. We've always taken pride in trying to find those meets that we can really make sure that we have a good team atmosphere and that we're looking at the needs of all 230 swimmers. And as I said, some hard decisions have had to be made. And let me just kind of give you the process of which we've had to go through and I've gone through to make the decisions that we've made. And I know some of you will be disappointed, frustrating, and probably upset, and I understand that. We are still dealing with facilities that are not open to outside programs coming in and events. So the MIT meet, where we sent approximately 35% of our team, is not being run as we know it. It is on a much smaller scale. A different team is running a meet. The time standards are much tougher, which where we at one point could take 75 to 80 swimmers to MIT, we'd be looking at 20 swimmers, possibly going to the meet up in Massachusetts. Then we also looked at a meet down at University of Maryland that's being run by Nation's Capital. We talked with them. They were willing to look to having us come to that meet, but that is even more strict. Those entries were done by USA Swimming's on-meet entry database, which were all pre-proven, which gave us very little wiggle room to kind of maybe slide someone in who might be right there an event and as a coach's call. So we had to nix that. Was reached out by a coach in southern New Jersey that's running a meet at a facility down there. Unfortunately, to be 11 and over, no 10 and unders. And again, those time standards were pretty tight that, again, we'd probably only be looking at maybe 20, 25 swimmers. Doesn't really meet the needs of our team. Then we looked at a meet in Long Island, which we had not been to in quite some time. That meet is being run. The time standards have been tightened up a little bit because rather than running the meet in two courses, it's only going to be run in one course, and it'll, rather being on a first come first serve, it's going to be done on time. So we will be sending and intend to send a large entry to get as many of our swimmers into that meet as possible. What I had to then do is reach out to Nashville Aquatic Club, which is a meet we had not been to in about 5 years. That meet was full, but they have given us an opportunity to take about 15, maybe 16 swimmers down, which is the first weekend in December, and we'll be doing that and mainly looking at our Y National qualifiers, our nationally ranked swimmers, and those that are just knocking on the door. And I know that that definitely is a frustration, and as the invitations are handed out, if someone's not able to come, we will look to fill that slot. And then the final meet, which both Long Island and the other meet that we look to attend, is a meet up at Southern Connecticut, which we have not been to for a number of years, but also looks to be quite deep and offers some great opportunity for racing for all of our swimmers ages 9 and over. That following Friday, on Friday the 17th of December, we will be hosting an 8-and-under quadrathon. And then that Saturday, we have our annual Blue-Red meet, so we have some exciting things and some fun things planned there. Those invitations for the mid-December meets look to be coming out from your coaches, if not tomorrow, Saturday, by Tuesday at the latest, so that we can get you that information and get everything up and going there. Some other things that we have coming down the pike that we're pretty excited about as we head into the new year. We have Olympic coach Greg Troy, who is Caleb Dressel's coach. He will be coming to the team in early spring, kind of late winter. He didn't want to come up from Florida when we had a chance of snow, and he will be working with all the practice groups. He'll have meetings with some of the swimmers, with the parents, and as well with the coaches, and just to be able to see what we can do a little bit better for the coaches, or excuse me, for the swimmers to be coached by an Olympic coach, see what are some of the sets that Caleb's done, other swimmers that he's coached through the years, and he has great experience and knowledge, and we're excited about that. We've reached out through Speedo and have contacted the agents of two very high-level current Olympians. We don't know what the status of that is, but and I'm not going to give out any names because I don't want word to get out. So we're hoping, fingers crossed, that they will be able to come to Westport as well. We also will have Brendan Hansen, who is a multiple gold medal Olympic champion as well as former world record holder. He will be coming out as part of USA Swimming to talk with our program and work with us as well. So I think that's an exciting time. We are in conversation with a sports-based nutritionist who has worked with professional teams such as the Philadelphia Phillies, hockey teams, numerous NCAA programs, as well as USA Swimming, to be able to offer some insight and knowledge and whatnot with making sure that all of our swimmers across the board for all levels make sure they're getting the high test fuel into their system. We're also in the process of reaching out to a sports psychologist to kind of help swimmers better prepare mentally as they head into competitions. What are some of those roadblocks that might get in our way? What are some things that we can really get up on the block with a little more confidence? So some exciting things on the horizon, and we feel pretty good about what we have going. The final thing I'd like to end with is with regards to SafeSport. Yes, you have gotten a lot of emails about having to take the SafeSport training. Here's the thing. In order for us to be able to run meets in the future, it is going to be mandated by USA Swimming that all of our parents be SafeSport certified. It's going to be a criteria for us to even be able to host swim meets. It's a challenge, especially if you have children in other programs and they require you to take that as well. That is one of the questions that even Connecticut Swimming's SafeSport coordinator has asked of what can we do just to unify and make it so parents are not doing one for swimming, one for soccer, one for lacrosse, one for ice hockey, one for archery, gymnastics, that we can just make it one uniform SafeSport course. Until that comes, unfortunately, you're going to have to take the SafeSport course with USA Swimming. It's on the Learn tab, and if you all can do that, that would be great. It's something that we're mandating and making sure that everybody takes a part of and gets certified. So I close with that. Please reach out to your coaches if you have any questions. Let me know if you have any questions. And those are just some items right there. And have a great day. Go Rats.